Apple's brand new M4 MacBook Air is officially out, and you know, the question on everyone's mind is pretty simple. Can it really truly blow away the latest and greatest laptops from Intel and AMD? Well, we're about to see if all that hype is real. Look, we're gonna cut right through all the confusing benchmarks and tech jargon to show you what actually matters when you're picking your next laptop. We'll translate all these numbers into real-world speed so you can decide for yourself which machine really earns its price tag. Let's find out who takes the crown. So, let's meet the main players squaring off in today's comparison. In one corner, we've got the new MacBook Air, rocking that M4 chip. And in the other corner, we have the perfect setup for a test. I mean, it's two ASUS ZenBook 14s that are pretty much identical in every single way, except for the processor. One's got an Intel Core Ultra 5, and the other has AMD's Ryzen AI 7. This gives us an incredibly clean head-to-head battle between just the chips themselves. Okay, let's dive right in, starting with the absolute heart of any computer, its raw processing power. And wow, the results are, well, they're immediately obvious. In both single-core and multi-core tests, the M4 is just in a totally different league. So think of it this way. Single-core is like a sprinter. How fast can it handle one really intense task, like opening a massive photo? And multi-core is like a master juggler. How well can it handle a dozen browser tabs, streaming music, and a file download all at once? In both of these races, the M4 just pulls way, way ahead. But honestly, this next point, this is the real game changer. When you unplug these laptops, the M4's performance, it barely even flinches. It stays just as fast. The Intel and AMD machines, though, they slow down. You can feel it. They throttle back to save power. So what does that mean for you? It means if you're working from a coffee shop or on a plane, the M4 is giving you the exact same peak performance you get at your desk. And that is a huge, huge advantage. So, okay, the M4 wins on paper. But what does all that power actually feel like when you're trying to get real work done, maybe on a deadline? Let's take a look at a real-world creative test that really pushes these machines to their limits. For this test, the reviewer exported a video using DaVinci Resolve, which is a pretty demanding professional editing program. The M4 MacBook Air, I mean, it absolutely flew through it. It finished the whole thing in under 8 minutes. Now check this out. The AMD ZenBook took over 13 minutes to do the exact same job. In an Intel machine, it was even further behind, clocking in at nearly 14 minutes. Just let that sink in for a second. For a really common creative task, the M4 is almost twice as fast. That's not just a tiny improvement. That completely changes your workflow. And don't go thinking this kind of speed is just for, you know, Hollywood editors. The reviewer actually shared this story about a TikTok creator they know who saw a massive real-world improvement in how fast they could get their videos out after switching to the M4. This just goes to show whether you're a seasoned pro or just starting out, this performance boost saves you real, valuable time. All right, time for round three, the AI test. You know, AI tools are becoming a part of everything we do. So how do these new chips handle the really unique demands that AI tasks throw at them? So the test looked at something called tokenization speed. What is that? Well, think of it like this. For an AI to understand what you're writing, it first has to chop it up into little pieces, words and phrases called tokens. The faster a computer can do that, the quicker and more responsive your AI assistant feels. It's really the difference between having a smooth, natural conversation and a frustrating, laggy one. So what's the M4's secret weapon here? It really comes down to smart design. Apple's M4 chip is built from the ground up to use its powerful graphics, the GPU, to help out with AI tasks. The Windows laptops, on the other hand, at least in this test, kind of just lean on their main brain, the CPU, leaving all that extra graphics power sitting on the sidelines. It's a fundamental design advantage, and it really pays off in AI performance. Okay, so we've established the M4 is an absolute powerhouse. But a laptop is so much more than just speed, right? What about battery life? What about the price? And what about the overall value you're getting? When you look at battery life, yeah, the M4 Air does squeeze out about an extra hour in a typical workday test. But let's be totally clear here. With the ZenBooks hitting around 8 hours, all three of these machines give you fantastic all-day battery. No one is going to be complaining about endurance on any of them. And that really brings us to the heart of the decision you have to make. If what you care about is pure power, amazing efficiency, and you're not locked into specific Windows apps, the M4 Air makes a ridiculously strong case for itself. But And this is a big but. If your job relies on software that only runs on Windows, you know, specialized engineering programs or certain business apps, then the ZenBook's compatibility isn't just a nice feature, it's an absolute necessity. So, after all the benchmarks, after all the real-world tests, we're left with the final decision. Which one of these is the right fit for you? Let's break it down one last time. The M4 Air is without a doubt the champion of raw performance, creative speed, and power on the go. It's really built for people who want the absolute maximum performance without any compromise. The ZenBooks, on the other hand, they're the champions of flexibility. They open up the entire vast world of Windows software, a huge library of games, and an operating system that millions of people know, love, and rely on every single day. And, you know, this whole comparison leads to a really fascinating question about the future. As the hardware on both sides gets just unbelievably fast, and as more and more professional software works on both Mac and Windows, does the operating system you choose actually start to matter less? Or does it begin to matter more as the unique features of each ecosystem become the main thing that sets them apart? That's the big question to chew on for your next laptop.
If you enjoy this video, please like, share, subscribe, and hit the bell to the latest update from my channel. Thank you for watching till the end, and see you in the next video.